racked with pain, and your health you can't regain. Bring your needs to Jesus, take them to the Lord in prayer. Whatsoever you shall say will be yours when you ask in faith. Put a name on your need and claim it in Jesus' name.
Amen. Praise God. Amy Grant says, name it and claim it in Jesus' name. Believe it and receive it in Jesus' name. If you have a financial need, according to the scriptures, you shall receive. Philippians chapter 4, verse 19 says, amen, that our God, he shall supply all of our need according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. If you are seeking after the Holy Ghost, it's a gift of God, you know. Acts chapter 1, verse 8 says, after that the Holy Ghost is come upon you, you shall have power, and you shall be witnesses unto me, both in Jerusalem and in all Judea, in Samaria, and the uttermost part of the earth. Amen. Name it and claim it in Jesus' name. Believe it and receive it in Jesus' name. We welcome you to another broadcast of the Word Ministries. We thank God for you tuning in. Amen. Praise the name of God. And I pray that you're in blessing for another great word from the Lord. Amen. Amen. No glory to myself. Amen. I give all the glory, honor, and praise to my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. For without him, amen, we can do nothing. The songwriter says, without him, we would fail. We would be like a ship without a sail. Amen. But I thank God that with him, all things are possible. This program today goes out to all of our sick, all of our shut-in, those that are in the hospitals and nursing homes. Amen. Our prayers are with you, each and every one of you in your home. If you're sick on the bed of affliction, I thank God we're bringing the Word of God to you. Amen. Just lay there and rest. Amen. And feast on the Lord. Amen. And I also pray in agreement with you. Amen. That the Lord will touch your body. God said that he would that we prosper and be in health, even as our soul shall prosper. So it is the will of God, amen, that we prosper, that we be blessed, amen, spiritually blessed, naturally blessed, physically blessed. Praise the name of God. Be in good health. Amen. God wants us in good health. Praise the name of God. Amen. And he wants us to be blessed, and he will bless us. Amen. Praise the name of God. And we're thankful for that. So we just want to pray with you and encourage you to just not to be weary in well-doing, for in due season you're going to reap if you faint not. I know the tears may be flowing from your eyes right now, but that's all right. The Bible says they that sow in tears shall reap in joy. Amen. What has you crying now? God going to give you a day of rejoicing. You're going to reap in joy. Weeping may endure but a night, but joy comes in the morning. Praise the name of God. And I'm thankful and grateful to God to know that today, amen, that joy is coming in the morning and that the joy of the Lord is your strength. Glory to God. Let us go to the throne of God in prayer. Amen. The Bible says, where two or three of you are gathered together in my name, touching and agreeing, there am I in the midst. Jesus Christ is in the midst as we are about to pray. We pray in agreement together, for there is power in agreement. Amen. Whether it's cancer or kidneys problems or high blood pressure, sugar diabetes, trouble with children, trouble on the job, I just want to pray in agreement with you. The Bible says, amen, that God is able to keep us from falling, present us faultless before the presence of his glory with exceeding joy. Amen. He's able to save them to the uttermost, all that come to him by faith. He's able to do exceeding abundantly above all that we ask, all that we think, all that we imagine, according to the power that worketh in us. Let's allow God, amen, to work the power in us. Amen. Let's present our bodies to him. Romans 12 says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that what? That you present your bodies. A lot of times you feel like you can present your money and nothing changes. Amen. God, amen, is not just concerned with you bringing money to him. God wants this temple. Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost? This body that he gave us, amen, amen. God's desire is to dwell on the inside of each of us. If Christ dwelt on the inside of each of us, this world would be a great, wonderful place to live. Praise the name of God. Amen. Praise the name of God. But amen. Why don't you make it an individual? If someone else refuses to let him dwell on the inside of them, why don't you be the example and let him dwell on the inside of you? Paul realized the importance of that when he said, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies, this temple that belonged to God. Present it as a living sacrifice, alive to God, dead to the things of this world. The outward man perish, but if we present our bodies to God, the inward man will be renewed day by day, holy and acceptable unto God. And since you can't do that on your own, you just have to say like Isaiah, here I am, send me. And after you've done that, presented your body, holy and acceptable God, don't boast, don't brag, it's our reasonable service. And if you really want to do what's pleasing to God, do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you might prove that which is good and acceptable and the perfect will of God. If you're looking for an example and you can't find it in man, you can find it in Jesus. He is the supreme example of love. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man will lay down his life for his friend. Amen. And then he said, as amen, I have loved you. He provided for you. He made ways when there seemed to be no ways. He brought you out of hospitals. He brought you out of car wrecks. All that love. He looked beyond all your faults, saw your every need, never condemned you. Man, never put you down. He didn't get rid of you. He didn't toss you away. Then he said, as I have loved you, love ye one another. He loved us unconditionally. He loved us, amen, when we did not love ourselves. As I have loved you, love ye one another. You may say, I got enemies. Love your enemies. You may say, I got people that use me just despitefully. Pray for them, which despitefully use you. I got those that hate me. Love them that hate you. They curse me out. Bless them that curse you. They always pulling me here, pulling you there. If a man compare you to go 1 mile, you go with him too. He took this from me. He took that from me. If he take your coat, Give him your cloak also. He hit me here, he hit me there, lies here, scandal here. If he smites you on one cheek, turn the other cheek. Now I say that, admittedly, it's easier said than done. But through the power of Christ, hallelujah, you can love your enemies. You can pray for them which despitefully use you. You can bless the very one that curse you and love the one that hate you. Hallelujah. Not within yourselves, but through Jesus Christ. So as we go to the throne of grace to pray, I pray in agreement with you. If there's anyone that has wronged you and you're not, haven't forgiven them, for your sake, forgive them. Praise the name of God. For your sake, forgive them. If you've sinned, and all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, the Bible says, I would that you sin not. Sin is the Mr. Mark. But if you sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Christ Jesus, the righteous. And what we ought to do if we confess our sins, God is faithful and he is just and he will forgive us our sin and he will cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And I'm thankful for that, for his forgiveness, for his compassion, for his love. Father in heaven, we thank you right now for your goodness, for your manifold blessing that you have bestowed upon each of us. We pray the will of God be done in all our lives. We pray, God, your power rest upon us. We pray, God, your grace and your mercy be with us. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray for those that are sick in their body. Lord, by your stripes, they are healed. I pray the prayer of faith, and you, God, shall raise them up. Touch that body that is sick in the hospital, the one that is in the nursing home, the one that's at home on the bed of affliction. We declare and decree that by your stripes, we are healed. In the mighty name of Jesus, those that are going through one storm after another, one trial, one situation, one circumstance after another, we pray your will be done in their lives. In the mighty name of Jesus, let your word be performed. Let it take free course in our lives. In Jesus' name, we present our bodies as a living sacrifice. Use us as an oracle unto thee. Have your way, God, and we'll give your name the honor, your name the glory, and your name the praise. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And thank God. Amen. We're going to continue on with part two of last week's lesson text coming from 2 Corinthians chapter 12. And it was talking about grace to face the race. We talked about what grace is. Grace is the free, unmerited favor of God, manifested in the salvation of sinners and bestowal of blessings. And because it's free, none of us can boast and brag about it. Because it's unmerited, none can say, amen, I got grace because I do this and I do that. I stopped doing this, I stopped doing that, I stopped going here, I stopped going there, so I got grace. No, grace is God's unmerited favor. Amen. God had grace on you, amen, when you come into this world. Before you stop doing what you've been doing, before you stop going where you're going, God had grace on you. Amen. Praise the name of God. Amen. When you become saved, can I tell you something? It wasn't nothing you done. Ephesians chapter 2 says, for by grace are you saved through faith, not of ourselves, not of works, lest any man should boast. It is the gift of God, and it's a free gift. gift that all need is the gift of grace. It is essential to all. It is needful for all. It is important for all. It's there. We just got to recognize it. And that grace that give you strength from day to day, that grace that provided you a living, that grace that take care of you, protect you from dangers seen and unseen, that same grace will help you to face the race. It'll help you to confront what you're going through. It'll help you to get through what you're going through. The grace of God will get you there. Amen. Through many dangers, tars, and snares, a songwriter says, I have already come. Amen. But it was grace that brought me. It was grace that taught me. And it's grace that will lead us on. The grace of God will help us to face the race. The grace of God, amen, will help us get through, amen, the battles of life. Amen. Praise the name of God. That's why we got to learn how to give it over to God. Amen. And depend on Him to give us grace to face the race. Sometimes, amen, it feels like I need to go hide under a rock. But God said, with my grace, you can face it, my brother. With my grace, you can face it, my sister. What you're going through has been hard. You may say today, amen, you don't know what I've been through. You don't know what I'm going through. And you may be right. I don't know what you're going through. But there's somebody looking at me right now, amen, wondering how you're gonna get through. I stopped by to tell you grace will get you through. God will give you grace to face the race. God will grant you grace, amen, to get through your dilemma. He'll get you through your sickness. It'll get through your heartache and pain. Amen. For Romans chapter 8, verse 28 says, and we know that all things work together to the good of them. To them which are called according to His purpose. See, it's through the grace of God, God allowed some things to happen. God allowed some people to walk away from us, to put us down, amen. But grace, hallelujah, is there so you can face the race. God, amen, has a purpose for all our lives. And sometimes to get through that purpose, amen, we need grace to face the race. We need grace. Hallelujah. Come times, amen, the enemy comes in like a flood. Hallelujah. Bills are due. House note two, telephone disconnect, waiting on the next paycheck. But grace will keep your lights on. But grace will keep food on your table. But grace will sustain you when the money is funny, when the change is strange, when your credit can't get it. God will give you grace to face the race. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank God for His grace. Yeah. We're living in perilous time. Sin is everywhere. Where is grace? Paul said in Romans 5, where sin abounds, the grace of God did much more abound. God will give you grace when there's wars and rumors of war. God will give you grace when the gas prices are hiking. God will give you grace when the children are acting up. God will give you grace when the job ain't going right. God will give you grace when your body is aching with pain. God will give you grace when you got a joy, amen, that you need. Grace will give you joy in sorrow. When you're uncertain about what's going to happen, God will give you hope for tomorrow. He'll be a bridge over troubled waters. He'll be there when they turn their back on you. Grace said, I'll never leave you, nor will I forsake you. Lo, I'm with you always, even to the end of the world. I heard Apostle Paul in the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter number 12, said there was given to me a thorn in the flesh. I don't know what it was, but he said a messenger of Satan to buffet me, to torment me. So I implored to the Lord. I besought the Lord three times that it might depart from me. Lord, they won't leave me alone. Lord, it's getting hard and heavy. Lord, I don't know what to do. Jesus said, my grace is sufficient. I got enough grace to sustain you. I got enough grace that'll help you face it. When you go through the race, yeah, get yourself ready. Get yourself prepared to face the race. What do I do? You lift your eye to the hill, from which come your help. Your help come from the Lord, which made the heaven and earth. If you want grace to face the race, Proverbs says, lean not to your own understanding, but trust in the Lord, and in all your ways acknowledge Him. Grace will direct your path. Yeah, He'll get you ready to face the race. Grace will give you ready to face the race. I heard Apostle Paul say, let us lay aside every weight and the sin with thou so easily beset us. If you're wondering why the load is weighing you down, if you're wondering why the weight of the world is on your shoulder, you need to take inventory. You need to examine yourself. Let us lay aside every weight, every sin that thou so easily beset us. Let us run. Let us run this race with patience. Like a marathon runner, you got to put down your heavy stuff, your stress, your oppression. Give it to Jesus. Yes, He'll bear it. Yes, He will. He promised to take care of us. And He'll take care of us while we're going through. There's grace to face the race. If it wasn't for grace, I'd have to throw in the towel. I'd have to throw my hands up and say, what's the use? But grace will sustain you. He said to Paul, my grace is sufficient. In the time of your weakness is when my strength is made perfect. Hallelujah. Praise the name of God. Hallelujah. I can see how he gloried in infirmities. He bragged on his weaknesses. Why? So that the power of Christ may rest on me. Thank you, Jesus, for the power of Christ. You may be having trouble running this race. Remember, it's not a sprint. It's not a 50-yard dash. It's a marathon. It's a lifetime. God will grant you grace to face this race. The race is not given to the swift nor to the strong, but he that endureth to the end shall be saved. And to endure to the end, we need to rely on grace to face the race, because sometimes it gets hard. Sometimes burdens are hard to bear. The body don't always feel like going, but God will give you grace to face the race. You've been through so much with children. You be like, Calgon, take me away. But God will grant you grace to face this race. Be encouraged. Let us not be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. People that we read, teach, and preach about, amen, paved the way, showed us what God can do. Hallelujah. And he can do it. If he done it for Paul, if he done it for David, if he done it for Job, he'll do it for you. Hallelujah. Whatever you need God to do, just call on him. He'll give you grace to face the race. He'll give you the endurance. He'll give you the strength. In the meantime, in between time, there are some things that we can do to help us face the race. It's only grace that we're able to do it. Amen. But here's the instructions. Basic instructions before leaving earth. The Bible, the Holy Bible. Amen. It'll lead and guide us. God will give you grace to face the race. God bless you.